A university in Ireland will soon offer the country's first ever degree in social media influencing, where students will learn how to avoid being canceled.
Great.
Now listen, the lead to that story, I get it. You're cringing, right? I cringed when I first heard about this. But I think a case could be made for this curriculum. Let me give you the details and you can decide for yourselves. So this is a Bachelor in Arts of Arts, I should say, in content creation and social media. And it will be offered specifically at Southeast Technical University. Now applications will open in November and the first cohort will begin in September of 2024. Now the degree will cost non-EU students about $10,859 annually, which for us Americans is quite a bargain. But you know, if you're not in the EU, you do have to pay that tuition. Now based on some of the recent polling done among young individuals, it's pretty clear that there is a market for this kind of major. A pretty shocking number of people want to be influencers. For instance, according to Forbes, 1 in 4 Gen Z Americans want to become an influencer, with a higher visibility survey showing that 16% of respondents would even pay money to become one. It's a bit of an issue in my opinion. Now the university said the program will be an opportunity for wannabe influencers to put all that screen time to good use and prove to family and friends that a career can be made using digital devices. It also cited experts saying that the global influencer market is worth around $21 billion, which proves that the employment opportunities in the digital media industry are endless, it said. No, I actually have gone back to the other side of this sounds like a bad idea. And the reason why I say it is because it is looking at the influencer career path through rose-colored glasses. Because what you think of are the bigwigs, right? You think of the people who are.
Thank you.
Right. You're thinking about the people who rake in the dough. But what doesn't get talked about enough is, first of all, how much of a grind it is and how many people don't make enough money to survive.
Well, you should teach a class there and tell them that.
I mean, look, we're doing okay. I think we're doing okay, we're successful, and you want like to build a legit company that employs about 100 people now, you said?
Yeah, roughly.
Yeah, I mean, if we were selfish, like a lot of other content creators and only wanted to hoard wealth for ourselves, we would be millionaires right now. But we're not going in that path and it is what it is. But the point that I'm trying to make is, yes, we are successful, but that took a lot of work. That literally took decades of hard work and there were moments when we didn't know if we were gonna make it. Now we succeeded, but there are countless others who haven't. And I think it's really important to, if you're gonna have this curriculum, at least make that clear to the students so they know what they're getting themselves into.
Yeah, no, I like the program. I'm in favor of it, I said it. But first, let me explain why people wanna go in this direction. Let me back up what Anna just said, and then I'll tell you why I like it. So look, the influencers are the new celebrities. It's not complicated. Like, people like to make fun, but did people wanna be George Clooney and Julia Roberts and Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie? Of course they did, right? And so that's normal for people to wanna be celebrities, and that's what the kids watch the influencers 10,000 times more than they watch, I mean, TV. TV doesn't even exist anymore for kids. I asked my kids, what is a CBS? And they said, is it a pharmacy? So literally, okay. So, and movies are in big trouble, etc. Number two, it looks easy and fun. So it feels, and a lot of them do it out of their bedroom. And the kids think, like, well, I got a bedroom, I can do it out of my bedroom. They do it out of the living room or the backyard. I got a backyard, right? So and then some of them make a ton of money. So why would it be surprising that kids would want to be influencers? That's like the most normal thing that I can imagine. And so that's point one. Number two, that means that a lot of people are going to try. Whether it's a good idea or a bad idea, they're gonna try. And so if they're gonna try, boy, do they need help. Because Anna's right, it's super hard. But look, we're the longest running show in internet history. So we learned everything the hard way. We had to do everything step by step and make 1,000 mistakes. But you don't have to make 1,000 mistakes. We already learned those lessons, right? So if they teach people, hey, this is what you wanna do, and don't get canceled kinda means don't say something that's gonna come back to bite you.
I see, that's the thing though. That's the thing. That essentially, like in an academic sense, codifies this culture of censorship and silence. Mm-hmm. Don't tell people what you actually believe. Don't tell, you should suppress your genuine feelings and thoughts as your whatever influencing the individual is engaging in. Right?
I know, Anna, but at the same time, if you're a 16, 17, 21 year old, you should suppress some of those thoughts. Okay, because they're gonna come back to bite you, because a lot of people say a lot of dumb things, by the way, me included, that then haunt them later in their lives.
I totally agree. And yes, I mean, I definitely subscribe to what you just said. However, if you're going to take the current cancel culture into account and essentially have that be the framework over what you should or should not say, I think that's far too suppressive.
Yeah, no, but that's why I like that it's in a university atmosphere, right? Mm-hmm. And so I would hope that in that class, they would have a super active discussion about, hey, where's the line? Is it that we're worried that someone's going to cancel us and cost us money, career, or reputation? Or are we worried about actually offending people and making them sad, or worried about getting our ideas out? And so, by the way, sometimes you do have to make people sad. I attack right wingers. That makes some of them sad, okay? It happens. And so you gotta know where to draw the lines. So as it definitely sounds funny, guys. There's no question that it sounds funny. I get that. But at the same time, it's a giant industry.
Right.
Now, what is it, like 30 billion or something along those lines? Or no, about $15 billion industry right now. Why wouldn't you have classes on any industry that's $15 billion? So it makes, I'm totally in favor of it.
By the way, there are actual skills that the students will learn through the program. For instance, business skills, video and audio editing, which can come handy if you decide to take a different path in your career.
100%, and by the way, can I just interrupt for one second? Because if you wanna be an influencer, a lot of people think, oh, I just grab a camera and I just talk. No, brothers and sisters, you're gonna, especially when you're doing it in the beginning, you're gonna have to do it on your own. You're not gonna have an army of people who volunteer to work for you for free. So and you're not gonna have much money if you're a regular person taking that class. So you have to learn editing and you have to learn video and audio. I remember I learned that stuff in public access TV before online even came out, right? So you gotta put in the hard work. I'm gonna end on that in a second, but give them more.
Yeah, so aside from the business skills, video and audio editing, there's critical cultural studies. I don't know what that entails, but it is listed as part of the curriculum. And also creative writing, which can be handy, not just in a profession of influencing, but in any profession. Writing is very helpful. Now, students will also need to take a mandatory module on crisis management as part of their studies. This sounds to me a little like what you would get in a public relations curriculum at a university. The crisis management module will delve into various social media crises, case studies or crisis case studies, with students analyzing the strengths and weaknesses of the crisis management responses. Students will then be assessed on a project in which they write a crisis management plan for a pretend crisis, which will involve writing a press statement and organizing a mock press conference. This is the area where I think the curriculum deserves the lowest marks, because the best crisis management in today's climate is to not apologize for what you've said. Uh-huh. Because if you're planning on putting out some press release or a statement where you have like a deeply felt apology and you're trying to like appease people, no, they're out for blood. They're not interested in your apology. And they will see your apology as an admission of guilt and they will try to destroy your life over that. So let's just keep it, that's the reality. That is the reality.
Look, Anna actually teaches a class, or used to teach a class.
I don't teach my students this, okay? So let's just be clear.
But if you taught them that class, that would do them a huge favor, because that's a school of keeping it real.
Yeah.
And so that is true, but at the same time, I mean, look at how vicious this industry is. That one of the classes they have to teach you is, you're gonna have to apologize, or you're gonna have to do some BS PR statement for an apology, because you'll get attacked. It doesn't matter for what, and nobody's perfect. And since you're living your life on camera, They're gonna rip you apart, so get ready for that. That I like. Last thing is, in entrepreneurial management, when I went to business school, the number one thing I got out of it wasn't accounting or statistics or finance. It was, holy cow, this is gonna be really hard. And so if they teach that, then that'll be a real service, because it's not just turning on a camera or a phone. It is super hard to make it work. Mm-hmm. So if you've got a passion and you wanna fight for it, then do it. And I'm 100% on your side. But if you think you're just gonna get rich quick, it is very unlikely.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.